Welcome to your second module of empathy training titled Empathy and You. We start with a vignette which led to a two-day argument between Mary and Stu, who were innocently having a nice meal with each other.
Please rinse the pasta bowl after you serve yourself so we don't stain the porcelain by letting it sit.
Porcelain won't stain. Everybody knows that. Quit treating me like a child.
I'm not treating you like a child. My grandmother gave me that bowl, and I'd hate to ruin it.
Do you want me to call Uncle Jerry, who sells porcelain, and ask him if you can stain it with pasta sauce?
You're such a child.
You are always trying to control my life. I'm 62 years old, and I don't need you to tell me about stains in a pasta bowl. The problem with you is you have OCD, and you're hormonal.
Mary and Stu are both empathy challenged. Stu because he was not sensitive to the emotional aspects of their interchange. Mary because she did not handle her frustration with her husband very well, which led to conflict and emotional disconnection. Our goal for this module is to teach you exactly what empathy is in its various aspects so that you and your partner can better handle pasta bowl type challenges as well as more serious challenges. More specifically, we will teach you four aspects of empathy and then ask you to ask yourself what you specifically need to work on to enhance empathy in your relationship or marriage. Let's start by asking the question, when you think of empathy, what comes to mind? If your partner sees you as empathy challenged, what is it exactly that she thinks you are a pint low on? Well, what is empathy? The short answer is that empathy involves awareness of the emotional aspects of yourself and your partner, as well as sensitivity to the emotional aspects of communication and problem solving. It also involves an awareness of the relationship itself as a separate entity that needs attention that you have both created with each other. Partners with high empathy have an appreciation and acceptance of the unique ways each partner sees the world, processes information, and communicates. Like different strings in the string section of an orchestra, empathetic couples influence each other's music, but don't try to change each other's sounds. In Module 2, we would like you to learn that there are actually four aspects of empathy, not just one. They are, number one, cognitive empathy. That's the art of taking the perspective of your partner, even though you may not agree with it. Number two, emotional empathy, having a feeling of emotional attunement and connection with each other. The third aspect of empathy is social awareness empathy. This is being aware of how your behavior is being seen by observers and being aware of how it is affecting them. The fourth aspect of empathy is called relationship awareness empathy. This is being more aware of patterns of behavior between you and your partner and sensitivity to the fact that most conflicts are co-created and fixed with contributions from both of you. Well, what's coming up in this module? Well, because we realize you can hardly wait to know more, we elaborate on these four aspects of empathy in upcoming lessons. Then we give you a short little quiz to make sure you have been paying attention. Seriously, once you understand the difference between them, you can focus more precisely on how to repair empathy issues in your relationship or marriage. Let's get started.